we said about sharing and love today, but you can see people with other religions, for example, like Buddhists, they really have the passion for good men. And how about Christians think about them? Because in some way they do differ from Christians, and they have more love.
Look at this. What you say actually is very, very important. Many years ago, they invited me and I went to Japan, to Kamakura. So, majestic place, like paradise. And there were Buddhist professors, and it was a Buddhist monastery, some also Taiwanese Christian professors from different sections. Yeah? And the Buddhists say, see Taiwan, they say, the Christians, they have so many sections in Yen, universities, rank, you know, others. How many they are? 5%, less than 5%. So they do something not successful. From the other point of view, you know, the Buddhists only recently, Zijin, for example, is doing in practical help. But before they did not so much care for the practical help. Why? Because important is the reincarnation. And even when you know, who started the Zijin, when she started, she has a lot of objections, okay, from different Buddhists. Once more I say, the love has not any color or any religious things. When we do something good, it is not honest to say, I will do something good for you, because I expect you to become Christians. This is, for me, an ethical blackmail. You understand what I mean? And, you know, I speak about Taiwan. I think the people in Taiwan, they are rich. I mean, they don't need food. But what they need is encouragement. For example, we have so many suicides in Taiwan, especially with young people. So what they need is a reason to live, a reason how to not to commit suicide because they failed the council, or you know, they created a scandal in their family and they commit suicide so easily. Most of the people, if you say a young Taiwanese, average young Taiwanese person, if you say to him, what's your purpose of life? I don't think he can say. He can say, well, I must work, finish the university, okay, I can make a family and then work very hard when I will be 60 years old, travel around the world, you know, and then have cancer and die. I'm sorry, but this is what I have heard.
That's true.
Right?
Older colleagues.
And where is the Christian message to this? If Christianity was not that you are guilty and Jesus died for you, who told him to die for you? And based, you know, on this kind of accusations of the others, and they give to the people a reason to live, what I say, to share your life, not to say, I want a wife, what color of the hair, blondie or, you know, black, eyes, blue.
This? He hasn't told his mother you can buy her a wig.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, I saw recently again. I saw the Japanese. No. They have now androids. You know, not android operating system. Robots, women, robots. Oh, actually, you cannot really. I mean, distinguish from a real woman. And their character are much more better because they're robots, right? They can do whatever you want.
But you cannot have a
descendant. So what? Who cares? Right? But then this makes what? That the human life is nothing. The other is good because he is unpredictable. Because
he's programmed to love you, so it doesn't matter.
If it is programmed, then this is not love, right?
If you want someone to love you, have a dog. Always a faithful love.
It's different because the human love is much more deeper. Because it's not because I cannot do different, but because I choose this. Okay, although my logic says to me, hey, you love this stupid woman, this will be an economic catastrophe for you. You say, yes, I love her. Why? There's no why. And yes, you sacrifice your career for her, your love, for your money for her, you say yes. Why? There's no why. This is the real love. When you make the love and say, I love her because she is beautiful, she has money, she is smart, or she is obedient, or I don't know what, she can cook very well. I'm sorry, this is not real love. So, you know, this is the Christian life. And this, I think, because we make Christianity religion, Christianity is not a religion. It's a way of life. If you make it ideology, you kill Christianity. So, I don't know, my meaning, what I mean is, if it is possible, you know, to make, to give to the people a good reason to live, and to make their lives worthy to live, and not to be afraid of the death, to live and to say, I love you forever. Why? Because this is it. And this is the happiness of life. The more you open, as I told you, God becomes food, right? It's food.
In the Chinese, what is forever? If they have an incarnation, what is forever? There is no forever.
Sorry, you know, because I must take everything here, sorry. Sorry, 1 minute, you know. Anyhow. Okay, forever, you know, forever, it's not a time, I think. I don't know, I'm sorry. I mean, my dream is to die to Taiwan, and I dedicated my life to the people of Taiwan. But what does it mean forever? Time is not a matter of forever. It is that as I exist because of you. It's not the time, like 1 year, 10 years, 100 years, 500 years.
Time is a human invention.
There is exactly, there is no, when we say eternity, what is eternity? Some people, unfortunately, especially many Protestant people, they say, what I care is not to go to the hell. But if you say to them what is the hell, they can describe a very bad place. But when you say, how about paradise? They say, well, not so, maybe praise the Lord every day. Actually, very boring place, right? Mm-hmm. Because, you know, every day do the same. It's not like this.
Or you just on a cloud all the time.
Yeah, it is, you know, a very exciting life. To become more and more and more full of love. Time is the measure of love, not the measure of how many years it is. And the measure of how close we are and how better we know each other and how better we know God. There is no end to this. Because God is infinite, don't think that the angels, they know God enough. There is always something exciting and fascinating to know. And there's no end to this. And the same is, this is why paradise is good, you know, because always it's so new, so fascinating to know you, to know you, to know others, to know God, you know, to what? There's no end to this. It's not a boring place. I go to paradise not because, not me, I don't deserve it, but not because I'm afraid of the hell, but because it is so amazing, so fascinating. At least it's worthy to ask this. So, love somebody forever. I don't speak about reincarnation because reincarnation is the end of the love. Why? Because in this life I marry you. In the other life I'm woman and you're man and you marry me. In the other life I'm animal and you are something and you eat me, right?
Then,
you know, there is, it's the end of the love. There is, we cannot talk about love there, right? You know.
That's how we find extinction with
reincarnation.
About what? Discovery.
Yes.
The Discovery Channel said there won't be any elephants after reincarnation, yeah, to be reincarnated.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Anyhow, so, you know, I don't know, but I would like really the church to be like a place where people freely talk. It's not the authority. You must believe this, and if you don't believe this, this is bad and this. No. It's a good thing, you know, to, how to say, to ask questions. I don't know all these questions, okay? I don't know. I cannot answer. But at least, you know, I can ask you questions more. Okay, I don't pretend that you ask the God and I'm God and I can answer every question. No, I cannot. And trust me, I can have more questions than you. Although I'm Orthodox, okay, I have more questions. So it is good to talk.
Because the more you learn, the more you learn you don't know.
Yes. Not only this, you know, you improve. And you see, God is dialogue. There is no dialogue in Taiwan. God is dialogue. Do you understand what it means? Dialogue means why it's this, and you say maybe this, maybe okay, you are wrong, and the other is right, and the other is more wrong, and the other is more right. But this is the pleasure of the mind, that we can make dialogue. And if we cannot make dialogue, you know, forget about it. Then we are machines, we are robots. So it is, you have something else just to take, you know. Really, I mean, I want, my dream is in this church after the liturgy to have coffee. Okay, today it was a little bit, you know, not so well organized. The water went for others and this, but we can have here something to drink, something to enjoy a little bit. I put these clothes next time I will not have, I will have some, just something simple.
I believe the word chaos is a Greek word.
It is, it is. Of course, yes, of course.
A little bit of chaos is always
good. Yeah, it is, of course. And here we have David, is a very famous scientist all over the world about chaos, okay? About the chaos theory, okay? Yes. So, what else would you like to talk today? It's good that we started. The starting is everything.